Hi, Creality has released a new software, Creality Scan 4 version 1.5.13, and it has a new feature that everyone is waiting for, model alignment. You also have a ability to switch between the perspective and orthogonal viewport. So this could be a very good addition to the software. They have fixed some bugs and optimized the color. And for the infrared scanner, now you can use the plane clipping function. But in this video, I'm going to test just this model alignment function, see how it actually works. And in this example, I'm going to make a 3D scan of this Indian motorcycle sprocket. A 1916 model. So use 0.2 for the resolution, scan in parallel lines and single lines. Okay, I'm going to fill this to scan 0.2. So now you have a view cube on the lower right corner of the screen that you can move it to different views. I click on the viewport, you can switch between orthographics and perspective, and you can also show the grid lines, set the rotational point so you can orbit easier. Let me align this to scan together using the manual alignment 2, and for number 3 I'm going to use bottom of the tooth somewhere here, number 3. Let's click on aligned. I can align with just to scan. See this? Let me click on exit. To be able to use the align model tools, you need to mesh your scan first. Choose 1 million, click on here. Okay, after meshing, let me check the scan data. See here, the key is taper, and I think the hole is taper too. Let me change to orthographic wheels. Yeah, the hole is also taper. I didn't know that. Scan is really clean and very precise. You see here, there's no seam lines between these two scans. You see this? The edge of the sprocket is very sharp. It merged perfectly. Okay, let's try the alignment function. Okay, this is the top view. So if I want to put this 90 degrees, okay, I moved it. This will be the top view. And if I put it here, okay, I want to align this using the edge of my monitor and align to this. Okay, so I think it's aligned. Click on apply front left back. I want to align the key to the, when you turn it, you need to click it exactly on the arrow. See here? If you don't click it on the arrow, it will be orbit. See here, if I click it just a little bit outside the arrow, it will turn into orbit function. So you need to click it exactly on the arrow to be able to turn. Click on apply. It's aligned as I like it to be. Perfect. I will export this to car compare to see if the alignment is safe. See, it's already aligned. So which one is faster, Creality Scan or Cloud Compare for the alignment? I think Cloud Compare is faster. See here, it has a 3-point alignment function, 1, 2, and 3. Now it's aligned just 3 clicks. And if you look at the top view here, this is the origin point. You can move the scanned data to the origin point using this function. So now the center of the hole is in the origin point. That's simple. But for the Creality Scan, you can only do the rotational alignment, but you cannot do the translation. So you cannot relocate the origin point of the scan. The hole of the sprocket is taper and the key is also taper. Let me change the size of the point cloud. And if you look at the sprocket, you can see that this side of the tooth is different from this side. The sprocket tooth has worn out. So when I reverse this sprocket, I'm going to mirror the perfect side of the tooth to the other side. It's definitely worn out. It's over a century old. Okay, let's try another example. I'm already in orthographic view. Click on aligned. You need to click exactly on the arrow. Sometimes it's, the arrow is very small. Next, I'm gonna move to this, rotating along the X axis. Red color. Okay, X axis move. Let me rotate along the Z axis. Click on here. Okay, click on apply. Top view. Align. Side view. Aligned. It's plastic. I need to do some adjustment. I need to move it just a little bit. Yeah, about this. And let's move it to this axis. Okay. Okay, I think this will be it. This could be helpful for some user, I guess. See, the size of the arrow is too small and you need to click exactly on the arrow to be able to rotate. You can move it by using a mouse clicking, but incremental is 1 degree. That should have a setting for you to change the angle incremental. And most important, you can't do translation. Yeah, it's better than nothing, right? They eventually put this function into the software. Thanks you guys for watching. I'll see you in the next video.